Yo, Cup of Joe here, and I've got a question for you all today. Who should carry the Rainmaker? There are upsides and downsides to letting anyone on the team carry it, but what's the optimal choice? I created a post on Reddit to see what you guys think, and the comments gave me a lot of different perspectives. Now that I've had time to draw my own conclusions, I'd like to give you guys my answer to the question, who should carry the Rainmaker? Let's start by talking about the pros and cons of having each position carry the Rainmaker, starting with the backline. The backline is usually the slowest weapon on the team, which means that if the backline is carrying the Rainmaker, then the rest of their team will be very mobile and good at taking fights. However, their team will also lose their longest range weapon, which will make them vulnerable to defenders in key positions. Furthermore, if the backline is carrying the Rainmaker, then there will be nobody to watch the Rainmaker's back to defend against flanks. Midliners often have swim speed on their gear, which makes them great Rainmaker carriers, and keeping the front and backline weapons in the game gives the team a nice balance of mobility, slaying power, and range. And finally, frontliners also tend to have swim speed, which is good for carrying the Rainmaker, but losing the frontline weapon means losing the best weapon for taking fights. It does also mean that the shortest range weapon will become a very slow, long range weapon, which, in some cases, can be just what the team needs. So, as you can see, some weapons are better suited than others for taking the Rainmaker, but there are reasons for anyone on the team to carry it. The real question we need to be asking is, under what circumstances should each position carry the Rainmaker? Okay, let's start with the weapon that should be carrying the Rainmaker the least, frontline. As I stated earlier, having the frontline take the Rainmaker is pretty bad for the team because you'll lose the team's most reliable fighting weapon, but there are still some situations where you'd want the frontline to grab it. When the Rainmaker is deep inside your team's base, you may need somebody to pick it up and just jump off the map with it to reset the Rainmaker back to middle. The rest of the team will be better at taking defensive positions while they wait for the frontline to respawn after that sacrificial play. When your team has a very strong lead and you just want to stall the game out, it can be a decent idea to turn the frontliner into a second backline by giving them the Rainmaker. This will give you the ability to play very defensively, but also makes it hard to push forward, which is why I only recommend it for when you are trying to stall the game out. When making this kind of play, the Rainmaker should be the first on their team to die, because this will put the game to a halt, which gives the frontline a little more time to get back into the game, while the rest of the team, once again, takes defensive positions. Next, we'll talk about when the backline should carry the Rainmaker. Giving the Rainmaker to the backline is the most aggressive option you can take, as it leaves your mid and frontline weapons in play. Your team will be susceptible to flanks since there won't be anyone to watch the Rainmaker's back, so I recommend letting the backline take the Rainmaker when your team has just gotten a team wipe and you're ready to go for a fast push. Midliners should be the ones taking the Rainmaker by default in all other situations. The midline's function on the team is to provide paint support and suppress key targets. If you think about it, those jobs can actually be accomplished by the front and back line if they work together, which makes the midline the most replaceable part of the team. Pushing forward with the Rainmaker while the rest of the team suppresses defenders is a consistent way to earn points, and it is very safe if you have a backline that can stay alive. Okay, so I've answered the question for you, but I can't make it so everyone on your team is on the same page. In practice, your solo queue matches will be filled with people with their own idea about who should be picking up the Rainmaker and when. So what are you supposed to do when your team keeps leaving the Rainmaker for you, the frontline, to carry? Pick it up! Sure, there's an optimal way to do things, but now that you have armed yourself with knowledge, you'll be aware of the pros and cons of having each position carry the Rainmaker, so you'll be better prepared to play around the weaknesses of whatever situation you find yourself in. Frontline picked up the Rainmaker before you could get to it? Play safe until they die. Backline grabbed the Rainmaker? Go aggressive and hope not to get flanked. Just do not leave the Rainmaker behind unless you know somebody behind you can pick it up. Having someone grab the Rainmaker to get some sort of push started is better than just having a standoff with your team all staring at the Rainmaker until an enemy comes and messes everything up. But then again, maybe that's actually a good bait tactic. Anyway, these are just my thoughts on the topic. I may be overlooking something, and your playstyle might call for different strategies, Hopefully this video has at least helped you get everything sorted out in your head so you can make better decisions in game. Let me know if this actually helps you rank up, and keep it fresh out there. Bye-bye.